Good evening, Canaan kids and families. Happy New Year to each and every one of you guys. We had a great start to 2021 in Children's Church. It was a great day, a great time of worship and studying God's Word together. The Children's Ministry is continuing to be moving forward at Canaan with Children's Church at 9 a.m. and Children's Journey Groups at 10:30. Make plans to join us in the Children's Wing this Wednesday night for Wednesdays Gone Wacky as we continue to learn about missions together. Also, I want to share with you our Wednesdays Gone Wacky theme for the whole month of January is the Mismatched Shoes and Socks Night, where two different shoes and mismatched socks. That's a tongue twister. Say that five times fast. Kind of tough. But I just want to remind you guys about that. So make sure to join us this Wednesday night for Wednesdays Gone Wacky. But before I share with you our Children's Church lesson with you tonight, let's have a time of worship with one of our worship songs from our Children's Church service. Let's worship together with the blessing.
Ah,
We're a great time of worship with the blessing, and I hope your kids were, your children were singing that at home this past evening, this week when they came home from children's church on Sunday, and they were humming it this Sunday morning and Sunday evening and tonight, and you probably heard it when they got it this morning for school. But hopefully, you continue to have that song reminiscent in your song in your head, as it's called the blessing. But tonight, I want to share with you our children's church lesson from Sunday, January 3rd. So go ahead and grab your Bibles. I know they're pretty close, and turn with me to the book of Acts. Acts is in the New Testament. Acts is in the New Testament. We'll be looking at Acts chapter 2. We're talking about how the Holy Spirit came in Acts chapter 2. And the title of our lesson is The Holy Spirit Came in Acts chapter 2. On the day of Pentecost, Jesus' disciples were gathered together in Jerusalem. And all of a sudden, a sound came from heaven. It was like a strong rushing wind, and it filled the whole house where Jesus' disciples were staying. Then tongues appeared like flames of fire, and they rested on each of the disciples. The disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak in languages they didn't even know. Now, Jews were in Jerusalem who had come from every nation. They have heard the disciples' voices in their own languages, and they were amazed. I mean, how could the men from Galilee speak so many languages? The question came up. And Peter stood up and said, I'll tell you what's happening. He reminded the people of something the prophet Joel had said long time ago. God says, I'll pour out my spirit upon all people. And Peter said, you saw miracles, wonders, and signs God did through Jesus. Even though God planned for Jesus to die, you used lawless people to nail him to a cross and kill him. But death did not keep hold of Jesus. God raised Jesus from the dead, Peter said. Peter also shared with them, he said, you have seen the truth. Jesus is alive. He went up to heaven to be with God the Father. The Holy Spirit convinced the people that Peter was telling the truth in what he was preaching and sharing. And Peter told the people to repent and to turn away from their sins and turn to God. Everyone who believed Peter's message was baptized that day. That day, about 3,000 people joined to be Jesus' followers and shared the gospel message with anybody they came in contact with. And the same thing that happened in Acts chapter 2, and the Holy Spirit came upon the disciples, and the disciples shared the good news, and Peter preached and shared the truth of God's word and his love and what God prophesied and the promises he kept, that we need to do that same thing. We need to be like Peter and share the good news and share the gospel with people we come in contact with. Every Sunday in Children's Church through the month, we have a big picture question. The big picture question is the question that maybe the first week we share it, kids don't know the answer right away, but by the end of the month, the children know the answers. They'll be shouting it when they're at home with you at home, or even here at Children's Church, or in person here at Canaan. So they'll shout out. They probably don't know the answer, but we have a new question for the big picture question of the month for January. And the question is, how does the Holy Spirit help Christians? I heard a couple this past Sunday, but here's the answer to that. The Holy Spirit comforts us, shows us our sin, and guides us as we live for God's glory. Let me repeat that question. How does the Holy Spirit help Christians? The Holy Spirit comforts us, shows us our sin, and guides us as we live for God's glory. So hopefully you'll be thinking about that. Your parents can help you remember that. And as you come back to church Sunday for Children's Church next Sunday, you'll be able to answer that question and shout it to the rooftops, because you know what. How does the Holy Spirit help us Christians? You know it off the top of your head. And I look forward to hearing you guys say that this upcoming Sunday. We're going to take time now to watch our Children's Church video of today's lesson entitled The Holy Spirit Came.
On the day of Pentecost, Jesus' disciples were gathered together in Jerusalem. All of a sudden, a sound came from heaven. It was like a strong rushing wind, and it filled the whole house where Jesus' disciples were standing. Then tongues appeared like flames of fire, and they rested on each of the disciples. The disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak in languages they didn't even know. Now, Jews were in Jerusalem who had come from every nation. They heard the disciples' voices in their own languages, and they were amazed. How could the men from Galilee speak so many languages? Peter stood up and said, "I'll tell you what's happening." He reminded the people of something the prophet Joel had said long ago. God says, "I will pour out my spirit on all people. I will show you wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved." Peter said, "You saw the miracles, wonders, and signs God did through Jesus. Even though God planned for Jesus to die, you used lawless people to nail him to a cross and kill him. But death did not keep hold of Jesus. God raised Jesus from the dead." Then Peter said, "You have seen the truth. Jesus is alive. He went up to heaven to be with God the Father. Do not doubt this." Peter continued, "When you killed Jesus, you killed the Messiah." The Holy Spirit convinced the people that Peter was telling the truth. "What must we do to be saved?" they asked. Peter told the people to repent, to turn away from their sins and to turn to God. God will forgive your sins and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. "Be baptized in the name of Jesus," he said. Everyone who believed Peter's message was baptized. That day, about 3,000 people joined Jesus' followers. They learned what Jesus' disciples taught, and they met with other believers every day. They broke bread together and prayed. God kept his promise to send the Holy Spirit. With the Holy Spirit's help, Jesus' disciples could begin their work to share the gospel with the entire world. God gives the Holy Spirit to everyone who trusts in Jesus as Lord and Savior.
Amen. As we continue to learn about the Holy Spirit came in this in Acts chapter 2, and hope your families will be reading that tonight, this evening, and just talk about that more as we continue to learn about that in Children's Church. And of course, we'll follow up with that in our series again for the month of January. So let's have a time of prayer. Dear Lord, we just thank you for this evening. Lord, thank you, Lord, for our Canaan kids and families, Lord. Continue to watch over them. Bless them and keep each and every one of them safe and healthy throughout the start of this year. Lord, I ask you to be with our children as they go back to their studies at school, whether it's in person or virtual or however they're going. Lord, I just ask you to keep them safe and also keep them studious as they continue to do their schoolwork, Lord. Continue to watch over our church family, Lord. Be with our pastor search team, Lord, as they continue to find the man you have for Canaan, Lord. And just ask you to continue to be with that whole process, Lord. Continue to be with our country in this time of transition, Lord. And ask you to be with the leaders and leadership, Lord. Continue to be with those in our family that are hurting or lost loved ones during this time, Lord. Ask you to give them comfort and peace, Lord. And ask you just to watch over us throughout the rest of the season, Lord. And look forward to our day tomorrow. In your name we pray. Amen. Okay, kids and families, I just hope and pray that you all had a great start to 2021. I'm so good to see you guys Sunday here at the church with Children's Church and Children's Journey Groups. And I just hope you guys have a great evening. And I hope to see you guys on Wednesday night for Wednesday's Gone Wacky. And Ms. Jamie and Rayleigh and myself tell you guys all Happy New Year. And we'll see you soon. See you later. Have a great evening. Bye.